they're very cryptic. They look just like the sticks and all the other underbrush that they live in. So when they hang around on top of the leaves and stuff, it's really hard to find them. The males are the ones that have the horn on its nose, and it's called a rostral horn because it comes right out of its nose. And then the females don't have the horn. What we notice is they have kind of like a bump on the tip of its nose, really small, about maybe the size of a scale or two. The male and the female are really, really small, thin, spindly looking lizards. Their legs are really long. Their toes are pretty long too. Ceratophora aspera is an endemic lizard to Sri Lanka, and its populations are under decline. So we want to find out how the populations are doing, if they're like interbreeding or not, if they're inbreeding, and see what problems they're facing right now. And based on what we find through phylogenetics, we're going to try and think of a conservation strategy to help the populations come back up. My father is a conservation biologist. He and I really enjoy doing the fieldwork together. There are other resident herpetologists that are there who have been a big help to the project. We would stay in the forest from like 8 in the morning till 6 in the afternoon trying to find them. We'd like kick around the leaves and stuff. Sometimes you'd see something run and it might be the lizard. The easiest thing to do is catch them by hand. So we essentially cut off about 3 millimeters or a little bit more off the tail, at the tip of the tail. Once I take them back, essentially use those tail tips to extract DNA from them, and that's what we use to do the genetics work. Provided I get an extension, I will definitely be going out in the summer to collect more samples. They'll be coming to Burke once I'm done with them. So that will grant other people access to use them. It's a resource for other scientists who want to study it as well now.